Welcome to this online service from St. Mark's Bromley on the fifth Sunday of Lent. The Lenten intensity increases with the inevitability of the suffering of Christ being anticipated. More of that later in the reflection after the Gospel reading and hymn. You will also hear choristers of St. Mark's sing the hauntingly beautiful Kyrie Eleison, Lord have mercy, and an anthem of the cross. Prayers have been written and recorded by Maureen Mattison, and the service ends with the blessing and organ voluntary. Let us pray. Gracious Father, you gave up your Son out of love for the world. Lead us to ponder the great mysteries of his passion, that we may know eternal peace through the shedding of our Saviour's blood, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
A reading from the Gospel according to John, chapter 12, verses 20 to 33. Now among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." Philip went and told Andrew. Then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honour. Now my soul is troubled, and what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven, "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The crowd standing there heard it, and said that it was thunder. Others said, "An angel has spoken to him." Jesus answered, "This voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of the world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself." He said this to indicate the kind of death he was to die. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The fifth Sunday of Lent today marks the beginning of Passiontide. Jesus is to make his way to Jerusalem. He will suffer and die. Next week is Palm Sunday, his entry into Jerusalem. And in church, traditionally, the long reading known as the Passion is declaimed, often as a bit part dramatic event, and in some places sung as a major choral work. The root of the word passion is suffering or enduring, and passion is at its core a form of pain that demands to be quenched. So even if we are passionate about someone or something, that is derived from deep inside, for which we are prepared to suffer or endure whatever it takes. It's not for the faint-hearted to be passionate. So we enter Passiontide today, and Jesus knows his time of suffering for his Father's kingdom will come soon. He's been trying to get his disciples to understand this all along. And there are times when he himself will cry out to have this time of trial taken from him. Yet, when the moment comes, he abides by it with passivity. Passivity, which again has the same root, as in the capability to suffer, to endure without resistance. And yet, a passive nature is not how we might have described all of Jesus' actions. Remember the cleansing of the temple, or his frustration with his followers and the Pharisees at times. But now he knows what is his vocation, his calling, in all obedience, albeit awful. He knows what he will do. "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit," he says eventually. This Passiontide and into Palm Sunday, Holy Week, may we who reflect on his word this day and always be mindful of our vocation and passions and courageous and wise enough to know when to take action and when to endure, when to rise up and when to be still, when to take up our cross and follow him. Amen.
We pray to our Heavenly Father, knowing that when we pray in faith, he hears us. Heavenly Father, in you we seek peace in the world, in our homes, within ourselves. we bring before you the troubles of the world, praying for the people of Myanmar, desperately seeking justice. We pray for a just solution to the enduring suffering in Mozambique, and we pray that church leaders there may be upheld and strengthened during dangerous times. We pray for sensitivity and honesty in those who lead the nations and the strength to temper power with integrity. We ask for your peace on our parish, on our homes and loved ones. May we set aside our busyness and enter your stillness. May our church and our homes become places of refuge, of grace and goodness, of peace and hospitality. We pray for peace within ourselves, for a lasting inner peace, where we hear your word and allow ourselves to be guided by your gracious love for us. For all in need of peace, we pray. Heavenly Father, in you we find perfect love. We give thanks for those who taught us love by loving us, who gave us self-respect by their respect for us, who gave us confidence through encouragement. We pray for all who suffer rejection, for asylum seekers, children abused and betrayed, for victims of domestic violence. Uphold them in their sadness with the assurance of your unconditional love. For all who feel unloved, we pray. Heavenly Father, in you we find wholeness and healing. May your comfort and consolation soothe those who are in pain, refresh those who are physically or mentally exhausted, and a lifeline to those in despair. We remember loved ones who are struggling with illness or weariness, including in our prayers Sue, Faith, Sue, and Rachel. For all in need of healing, we pray. Heavenly Father, in you we find rest. We pray for loved ones who have departed this life and are now in the light of life everlasting, remembering those known to us, including those named on our pew paper. We bring before you those who have died suddenly, unprepared and at the hands of violence. May they rest in peace and rise in glory, and may those who grieve be comforted. Through the saving grace of Jesus Christ, we have received the promise of eternal life and hope of glory. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.
Christ, give you grace to grow in holiness, to deny yourselves, take up your cross and follow him. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.